the University of Northern Iowa, a story of growth, maturation, and outstanding accomplishments. UNI has prospered recently in many ways, but no area exemplifies this exceptional success more than the athletics program. Constant progress and continued improvement have been our trademark. Challenging schedules and consistent achievement have brought unprecedented exposure to the athletics program and to UNI. Over the past few years, the University of Northern Iowa has built a Division I program on a very solid foundation. A foundation with a cornerstone of quality people. People employed as coaches, people recruited as student athletes, and people enticed to support the coaches and players. Great young people committed to athletic excellence and to a first-rate education. Talented staff people committed to successful coaching and to teaching motivation, strategy, training methods, and sports techniques. All great people expecting to attain tremendous accomplishments. Yes, the past years have been growth years, years of building a program of which everyone can be proud. It's been accomplished correctly, and in 1987 it became apparent that the plan was a huge success. The year started with high hopes for an outstanding football season. The Panthers were ranked in the preseason top 10 with the qualities necessary to win the Gateway and vie for the national championship. The schedule, however, was the toughest ever, featuring all Division I opponents, including Minnesota and Iowa State. Northern Iowa's task was formidable, but the Panthers were up to it. After a season-opening road victory over McNeese State, the team lost a hard-fought 24-7 game at Minnesota. But they bounced back with a vengeance and proceeded to go 9-3 the rest of the year, finishing fourth in the national polls. The campaign included key road wins at Western Illinois, Southwest Missouri, and a last-second loss to Iowa State. After defeating highly regarded Arkansas State in an exciting home playoff contest, the Panthers suffered a double overtime loss in the national semifinals to Northeast Louisiana, the eventual division champion. Halfback Carl Boyd was voted Gateway Conference Offensive Player of the Year and named second team AP All-American. He was also selected to the Kodak Division I-AA All-American team. All-conference quarterback Mike Smith also concluded an outstanding career in possession of practically every UNI passing record. Coach Daryl Mudra's Gritters have truly arrived on the national football scene, and the future looks very bright. The 88 season opens against powerful Pittsburgh and includes a rematch against Iowa State and a host of always tough conference opponents. The fall also sees the volleyball team take to the hard court, and 87-88 was a great time to watch the UNI Spikers. The Panther women compiled a 34-5 record, capturing their second straight Gateway title with an undefeated conference record. The Lady Panthers again qualified for the NC2A Division I tournament, but lost to perennial power Nebraska. Mary Bernhardt and Mary Ellen McCann were named first team All-Gateway, with Bernhardt also honored as Conference Player of the Year. Mary was UNI's first to play in the Hugo East-West All-Star Classic, where she received the Reebok Outstanding Student Athlete Award for volleyball. Bernhardt was a three-time first team Academic All-American and led her squad to an aggregate scholastic grade point average of over 3.0 for the year. Our women's volleyball team truly exemplifies all that is good in sport, with outstanding achievement both on and off the court. Coach Arabi Farge's Panthers must now tackle a challenging 88 schedule as they vie for continued conference and national honors. As good as the fall was at Northern Iowa, the winter held even more varied excitement. A nationally ranked wrestling team, rapidly improving basketball teams, swimming teams which rewrote dozens of school and personal records, and track teams who sent notice that the Panthers were forces to be reckoned with. all these men and women combined to create a great show for their fans during the cold Iowa winter. Kim Maiden's Lady Panthers won 4 of the last 6 contests and showed marked improvement over last year. Northern Iowa played exceptional games against the 2 top teams in the Gateway. The Panthers suffer the loss of Kim Smythe and all-time leading scorer Diane Roberts. But all-conference performer Chris Huffman returns, and recruiting for the future looks very strong. Eldon Miller's men's team also showed great signs of progress in the 87-88 stretch run. Although wins were hard to come by, the Panthers had steady growth and played some outstanding games against the nation's best. UNI challenged 7 teams which gained postseason tournament berths and defeated Louisiana State, a 1987 Final Four squad. Excellent contests with Iowa State, Southwest Missouri, and Cleveland State made it obvious that Coach Miller's team had improved markedly since that April 86 day when Eldon greeted his first squad of only 4 players. The 88-89 schedule sees us resume the series with Iowa and with Drake. It also includes dates with Iowa State, Dayton, Northern Illinois, and all the great rivals in the tough Mid-Continent Conference. Quality players, excellent coaching, and talented opponents make it a perfect time to be a part of the Panther basketball scene. While the Roundballers were captivating audiences in the Unidome, the wrestlers were challenging the nation's best. The Northern Iowa Grapplers have 3 All-Americans returning in Mark Schwab, Chris Lembeck, and Joel Greenlee, and the prospects for the future are bright. The 87-88 squad finished the season at 16-3 and placed 3rd behind Iowa State and Arizona State in the prestigious Virginia Duels. The Panthers also defeated Iowa State while the Cyclones were number 1 in the nation. Coach Don Briggs' wrestlers placed 13th in the NCAA Division I tournament, but will be prepared to challenge for the top 5 as the 88-89 campaign opens. UNI will host the Iowa Hawkeyes during the regular season, and a who's who in wrestling will comprise the coming year's schedule. Yes, it's great to be a Panther, and each year seems better than the last. Chris Bucknum's indoor track team was crowned league champs and hosted the Central Collegiate Championships. Jim Hall's swimmers bested personal, school, and conference records. The golf and tennis teams challenged the best in the Midwest. And the baseball and softball squads clawed their way to prominence against nationally ranked opponents. It's truly a group effort when it comes to building a fine program. Lots of people pulling together for a common goal. Dedicated coaches and student athletes who place team and school achievements ahead of individual honors. It's a great time to be a part of the Panther family. Purposeful recruitment of staff and students, complete dedication to hard work, and a commitment to challenge the nation's best. It's a formula which defines our mission and creates pride and devotion in all who involve themselves. Be a part of our success.